Hi, I'm 10-year-old Shaba Wale. Here's your Channel's TV news update for May the 6th, 2021. Finding a solution to the current security situation in the country is a collective responsibility, and the latest suggestion is coming from former President Olusegun Obasanjo that the federal government should develop means of dealing with kidnappers and bandits heavily in place of the payment of ransom. He made the comments on Wednesday in Abeokuta, the Ogun State capital, when he hosted members of the TIF professionals group and stressed the need for leaders to ensure the 2023 birth emergence of a new federation in the nation. Meanwhile, the National Space Research and Development Agency says inadequate satellites and other facilities affects monitoring of bandits and other criminal elements operating in the country. The newly appointed Director General of the agency, Halilu Shaba, says the bandits have become sophisticated in their operations. He says from waves received by the agency from remote areas, it appears the bandits no longer use GSM mobile phones but walkie-talkie. Mr. Shaba calls for collaboration between the agency and security agencies in the country in the area of information sharing, especially when planning to launch attacks on the criminal elements. The Nigerian Communications Commission and the Nigerian Communications Satellite have signed a Memorandum of Understanding to facilitate the deployment of 5G technology in the nation's telecommunications sector. Signing documents in Abuja, the Executive Vice Chairman of the Nigerian Communications Commission, Professor Umar Dambata, says Nigeria can't be left behind when several countries are already expanding their technologies through the 5G network. On the international scene, the United States has backed a move at the World Trade Organization to temporarily lift patent protection for coronavirus vaccines. India and South Africa proposed the plan, which they say will increase vaccine production around the world, but drugs manufacturers argue it may not have the desired effect. U.S. Trade Representative Catherine Tai says that extraordinary times call for extraordinary measures, and she warned that it would take time to reach an agreement on the matter. After a wait of 9 years, Chelsea end up speeding back to the Champions League final. Chelsea missed a host of chances but had more than enough to beat Real Madrid 2-0 to make the Champions League final on Wednesday night. The Blues were happy to cede possession earlier on, knowing they had the pace and movement to get at their Spanish opponents after turnovers in possession, and that proved a route to goal more than once. And that's the news update. Don't forget to join us later for the recap. I'm 10-year-old Shaba Wale. Thanks for watching.